过程导致的死亡量到底有多少，有没有人放生的人有没有去关注。
所以想看你放的100只里面就10只能活，那这个怎么叫做放生呢？根本就是放死。
台湾现在的放生已经走到了，就是说有良心的做错事，有善意的做坏事。
Even though Taiwan is only a very small island, it has an enormous biodiversity. The unregulated practice of life releasing may mean it is facing an irreversible catastrophe. The original intention of releasing lives was to set the captured animals free out of pity. It was meant to be a spontaneous act, but now has become a deliberate practice with many problems. Releasing animals, including many religious releasing activities, abandoning house pets, or farmers' careless releasing of edible species that are no longer profitable, without knowledge of their habits and habitats, leads to ecological impacts and environmental harm. This morning, tens of thousands of milkfish are loaded onto 7 big trucks to travel north from the fish farm in Tainan to Juwei, where a religious releasing ritual will take place. Votaries say that these fish will soon regain their freedom.
Because 啊、哦，吃太多众生肉了，
就是他头脑已经有伤到嘛，有伤到他昏倒，那个太久了啊，所以说现在来做这个活动也是说希望给他积一点那个啦，积点福啦，哦、啊给他消一消业障。
Mercy life releasing without a knowledge of habits of different animals usually means that many of them die. From an ecologist's point of view, this pity is actually cruelty.
你知道这个鱼类，不管你是泥鳅，你是什么东西，它基本上水温对水族的影响很大。第二个，它是到底是淡水还是海水，这也不能够不一样，不能不相容啊。那它就一桶一桶倒到那边去，一直轮转过来呢。那 A 型是水温 ，A 型是水质等等啊，你就看到呢，大部分的这个水族就翻身啊。
有一只鱼死掉了。
After the ritual, fishermen start to arrive. What have these lives suffered between release and recapture?For decades, many ecologists have warned against life releasing, but the practice remains popular. On the roads between northern and southern Taiwan, there are always people traveling who are a part of it. You may wonder why most birds for release come from the south.
Because 中南部它有比较广大的平原、农耕地，这些环境是非常适合这些鸟生存。那这些猎人也非常懂这些鸟的习性，所以通常那个诱饵一摆下去，网子一张，很快半天就可以抓上百只的鸟。他们从野外抓来的，那野外抓来的过程之中，它其实本身已经受到很大的紧迫压迫，而且这些猎人他们对鸟的这个安全跟它的这个维护不是那么注重，所以一旦鸟上网或者是运送过程中就会死亡的。
The well-intentioned practice of life releasing has created a market for businessmen, which now means that more people are catching more birds. These commercialized activities have been catastrophic to the animals. These avian passengers are either from Kaohsiung or Tainan. Their journey from the south takes 12 hours or more. Those who are lucky enough to make it will be residents of the famous Wanhua Bird Street. Wanhua Bird Street attracts those who keep birds as pets. Birds with colorful feathers or beautiful voices are caged here to be sold. The sparrows also benefit from this street, a convenient source of food, which probably seems ironic to the caged birds.
这些信众很虔诚地去参与这个法师的法会，这些鸟群完全没有人照顾它，因为他们在法会办的过程中是很冗长，时间太长了，而且一放的时候可能是十点半、十一点、十二点，接近中午的时候，这个时候是不适合放的。而且你放那么大量鸟类放到这个环境，别的环境，它本来就生存了一百只，好好的，你又放一百只进来，哇，搞不好就打架了，死伤惨重。
就好像说是行小善，但是实际上是做了大恶。当然这个恶我们不是故意去做的，可是实际上我们的行为导致的结果是导致很多生物的这个的受苦。
Avian expert Dr. Lucia Liu has found that a huge number of Chinese bulbuls have been brought to and released in eastern and southern Taiwan, which is endangering the existence of Stian's bulbul, an endemic Taiwanese species.
那当初呢，乌头翁被国外的学者采集到，把它在定位上把它定位为台湾的特有种，因为全世界只有台湾有白头有乌头翁。那这个乌头翁的分布呢，早年的记录，日据时代的记录是只有台湾的东部跟恒春半岛，就是台湾的南部。那白头翁的分布呢？原当年的记录是只有台湾的北部跟西部。那在当年日据时代的资料里面，他们也明确地说这两种鸟没有杂交。那在1989年我开始在太鲁阁做研究的时候，发现太鲁阁的就是峡谷里面杂交的个体非常的多。在那个之后，我就每隔几年就回去做调查，就发现说现在你要在太鲁阁峡谷里面找到纯的乌头翁其实已经蛮难的。杂交的状况好像是一个伤口一样，那我们会发现这个每一个溃烂的据点都在扩散，那新的放生的据点就是新产生的一个受伤的地方，然后慢慢它也变成溃烂的据点也在扩散。而且白头翁出现的据点常常跟放生以后就是放生行为发生的据点是相关的，就在那个的附近。所以我们相信在白头翁的这个分布扩张里面，放生应该也扮演了一个助长的角色。
Dr. Yiru Yang has studied frogs in Taiwan for 20 years and is a person most familiar with them.
There are four. 因为他都喜欢那个在这种山林里面，然后有这个水池，然后有隐蔽的地方，所以他叫的声音又格外的响亮。给给给，有可能你不知道他在那里。那如果万一这边有牛蛙，那这些就完蛋，因为牛蛙也是生存在这种环境，那根本这个就是它的食物了。
牛蛙是外来种嘛，哈，我们的名字的话就是北美大牛蛙，就知道它的来源是在北美这样子。那当初是因为了我们有人会吃野生的青蛙嘛，然后为了保护我们野生的青蛙，所以就引进来，然后让人家来吃这样子哈。
Then, people started farming American bullfrogs, and they soon became an item on the purchase list of life-releasing groups.
有一次在解剖在上课的时候，然后就学生跟我说牛蛙怎么嘴巴里面有卡了一个东西，就我打开一看，天哪，塞了一只台湾本土的共德式赤蛙。所以他们到野外去，那他们体型非常的大，大概长到15到20公分，所以那青蛙本身来说只吃活的，会动的都是它食物，它是不管你哦，不管是哪一种，反正是活的会动，比如它嘴巴小都可能是它的食物，所以它就会吃台湾本土的蛙类了。一旦让它在野外，其实你要让那野外生存了，而且有了第二代之后，你要让它请它离开，那是不太容易的事情，几乎是不可能的事情。
This is Sun Moon Lake, located in the heart of Formosa, and here is another unwelcome guest, the Indian glassfish. The kilauea sharp belly and Sun Moon Lake are just as important to the Shao tribe as the flying fish are to the Dao tribe.Providing artificial floating islands for the kilauea to lay eggs in and using boathouses and square nets to catch the fish are traditions passed down by the Shao ancestors. The kilauea fishing season has just begun this year, but these experienced inland fishermen have already been defeated by the Indian glassfish.
数量就是拢像安尼一直掠安尼吼，伊袂减少啊。但是即摆就是啊，伊生出来卵吼，伊只生出来卵袂复变的幼囝，就去个玻璃食掉去。它厉害的地方，最主要的繁殖力量很强，繁殖力量吼强的鱼吼，而且它好像没有什么天敌。它那個鱼上下都有那个像针一样的那个刺吼，你别种鱼也无在个吃。加了一张电视。
那么一直到今年，一直到今年就是三月的时候呢，是我们开始捕捉这个奇力鱼的时候，那发现用四角吊网捞起来的这个，这里鱼啊，几乎啊，50%-60%，50%-60%拢是玻璃鱼，才发现就讲这个物件非常非常的严重。
As identified by the Endemic Species Research Institute, the Indian glassfish is a kind of small perch that was introduced to Taiwan as an aquarium fish, but has now found a new home in Sun Moon Lake. It is obviously connected with the practice of life releasing.
来放生的话，因为热潭的这个潭面啊非常广阔了，那它放生的地点也不固定在什么地方，但是经常听到渔民啊这个。打电话来，就什么地方在放流的次数非常频繁非常频繁，一个月里面呢至少在5次-6次以上。从生态面来讲，它将来如果不把它这个赶快防治的话，将来可能整个潭面就是玻璃鱼的世界。
In order to more effectively annihilate glassfish and to compensate the fishermen's loss.Restaurant owners, under the guidance of the Fishing Association, reluctantly remove glassfish's bones and turn them into a side dish. The Council of Agriculture also purchases harvested glassfish from fishermen. In addition to commercialized live release activities and careless releases by breeders, pets abandoned by owners who have lost interest in them,are another form of random release, very likely to hurt these pets.
因为很多爬虫类，它所生存的国家、它的区域、它的气候都是不一样。像有些是比较高热、比较干燥型的气候，像台湾就它就可能不是了，因为台湾属于是海岛型，气候比较潮湿。如果你放掉，它会活，但是活不久，很快就短命。
Owning a pet is a lifelong responsibility.Some alien species come from climates similar to Taiwan. So, when they are abandoned, they quickly adapt to the wild and become invincible without their natural enemies. The red-eared turtle is a significant example.
This small fish looks like a little bit like a little bit, but it's a big fish, it can be about 30 centimeters. And when it's a big fish, the color will fade out, it will become a dark red color, it will become very ugly.所以很多人养到大以后就觉得它变丑，就乱丢。而且那种适应能力都超强，不怕冷，不怕热，不怕沾水。 对，它一样，它就是藻类也吃啦，鱼类也吃，所以它几乎你在外面看到，而且它生性有的大自然都蛮凶的，有的会欺负到我们原生种的乌龟。
一个生物进到一个它的不是它原来栖息地之后呢，它当然会就跟当地的生物产生食物上的竞争，产生空间上的竞争。好，所以当它如果它建立它族群之后呢，它会有很大的机会会把原生的生物给取代掉。
Researchers of the Taipei Zoo set up a net in Jingmei Creek for one night. They captured mostly alien species, tilapia, red ear turtle, Thai catfish. Of all of these, the number of armored catfish, also called the garbage fish, is surprisingly high.
以像景美溪来讲哦，在大概民国七十几年的时候，琵琶鼠的这个族群数量啊，大概只占那个地方的生物的所有鱼类的大概不到1%，但是到九十年代，就是现在哦。根据我们调查的记录来讲，它已经占景美溪的鱼类的总数量的大概40%左右。所以也就是说，景美溪现在鱼类里面有大概快有一半是琵琶鼠。啊，这个就是什么？这就是一个很典型的取代了。啊，它把一些原生的鱼类给取代掉了。
话说二十几年前呢，有一次我们在一个大的活动当中，那一次因为佛光山有建放生池。那当时候就有人拿乌龟啊，拿鱼来放生，那一次就发现说，鱼呢就被乌龟吃了，乌龟呢就会弄得整个水池，很多的鱼类呢生命没有保障，因为其实每一种动物它都有它生活的空间，如果我们特别去花钱买来做这种仪式，看起来是满足我们自己，要。种植福德因缘的心情，其实对动物啊是一种伤害，所以我们从那时候就再也没有办放生的仪式。大师就曾经说过，爱护动物就是在放生，甚至我们对于自己的生命的珍惜也是在放生。
如果我们真的要放生的话，我们真的要好好的去考虑说我们放的物种那适不适合这个环境，一个是它自己能不能活下来，第二个是它会把这周围环境里面所有东西全部消灭掉。如果说我们是用一种爱护自然，或者是像我们今天这个活动这样子，是一个主动来把一个自然环境维护起来，用这种方式的话，我觉得每个人都可以随分随力的做到。
In 2003, Zixin Foundation, following the principle of sustainable life development, began work with the Forestry Bureau and Taipei Zoo on a wetland conservation project in Xinfeng Farm. The once desolate farmland is now full of energy and life again. Today, Zixin Foundation called on nearly 100 school teachers to have a class at Xinfeng Ecology Classroom. Participants helped to pull out weeds.In the afternoon, we found the eggs of apple snails. It is an alien species that has caused much agricultural damage over the past 30 years.
其实台湾普遍很多地方都有，啊，所以农户都叫它夭壽的，没有天敌。
在台湾，
但台湾目前天敌不多啊，有人养鸭子吃它。
In the past, businessmen introduced apple snails for eating. But since they did not taste good, they were released on a massive scale in farmlands, which led to an ecological disaster.
有一个很重要的生态概念，就是说，很多生物不是它来破坏我们的自然生态，是我们破坏我们的自然生态以后，这些生物才立足下来，因为生态稳定的生态体系就会形成一个防护网，外来的种不容易进来。
Loving animals is not the same as deliberate life releasing, but instead an understanding of ecological dynamics and giving animals the help that they need.
是直接
哦，这是幼雏嘛？对啊，幼雏啊，哎，这个是你的龙。
那个给我看看。哦，你不让我买。
是民众来的话，我们会给他填这样的资料，就是说他们是在哪里捡到的。那留下这个资料，我们以后如果养成等他恢复的话，就是可以让他放回原来的地方。对啊，然后我们会用一些这样子的东西让他们保暖这样子。那这个天气还好，
像喂水啊，我们会滴在他旁边，然后让他直接，他可能就会直接吸进去，就像这样滴一些点在水会旁边。
因为照顾伤鸟，它其实就像我们照顾小孩一样，它其实是要有一些专业背景或是经验，才有办法照顾得好。我们有很资深的义工，然后很资深的兽医师，可以帮忙教这个民众他怎么照顾。
因为我们住在山区，附近有很多，有时候有受伤的鸟，有时候有就是落巢的鸟，那常常会看到会捡到，所以我们也曾经捡过这样子的鸟，但是因为旧伤没有很好的成效，所以想要来学习。
There are currently 13 wildlife rescue stations in Taiwan that care for wounded animals. They will be released to their original habitats as soon as they recover from their injuries.
那只老鹰是来自于苗栗，它被送过来的时候，因为它身体很虚弱、很消瘦，经过我们一段时间的调养之后，它慢慢恢复健康，再放在我们的野放训练笼里面，经过一段时间的飞行训练。到明天应该可以回到它野外。我们野放的原则就是在这个这只鸟捡到的地点，我们就在那个地点野放，就是在它的原来的栖地野放。其实目的就是尽量减少基因的混淆，还有就是野放回原来的栖地，对它来讲比较熟悉，比较容易存活下来。
The rescue stations rescued nearly 400 wounded animals in 2004.True life releasing is all about giving the animals proper care and helping them find the way home. Random releasing has devastating effects on Mother Nature, which are not counterbalanced by our good intentions. Only by learning to respect lives and Mother Nature can we preserve the beauty of biodiversity.
等一下，我们先把它放开。
还有鱼
啊！人家放的陷阱哎，是食蛇龟吗？
它是没有口。
它吃什么东西？
对，食蛇龟。
它用这个陷阱去抓。
食蛇龟是保育的呀。
是啊，
是。
对啊，是保育的呀。把它放进这个，这个就是真正的放生。
对，
这才是真正的放生。